Are you sick and tired of gambling your hard-earned money on Madden packs? Well, look no further than my sponsor, MMOEXP, for the cheapest and the most reliable MUG coins on the market. And don't forget to use code FERDY at checkout for 5% off. The link for their website will be right at the top of the description. Are you looking to take your Madden game to the next level? Look no further than Civil.gg for the best ebooks on the market. Choose one of two membership options, and don't forget to use code FERDY at checkout for 25% off. What's going on, guys? For our second video of the day, we are looking at the brand new limited time DeAndre Swift. Before we hop into it though, about half of you guys who watch the videos are actually not subscribed. So if you right now watching this is not subscribed with Noti's on, make sure you go ahead and do that so you do not miss a single gameplay, a single tier list, or a single upload. And the shout out for today's video goes to my man, it's your boy Ed. Shout out to Ed as always for commenting the emoji on last video. Okay, so here is the 95 overall DeAndre Swift. This card, I'm gonna be honest, is not worth it. I'm gonna say that right now. And no matter really what happens in this video, this card's not gonna be worth it. He's basically just, you know, Kamara and Jonathan Taylor with minus one speed. He is 5'8 though, so that build could be a little bit glitchy. 5'8, 212, that's kind of nice, I'm not gonna lie. But also does have some pretty interesting stats, like 95 spin, I believe is the highest, and 95 acceleration is also really nice. If you have a Lions team, this could be maybe a good bridge from Barry Sanders. I'd imagine that them dropping this card means that Barry isn't coming maybe until the new year or playoffs or something like that. Probably not playoffs though, he's a Lion, I don't know. Yeah, I don't know. Could be interesting, I don't know, but I feel like that this does kind of mean that we're not gonna get Barry for a while, or it could mean that Barry's coming out next week and they want all the Lions themed teams to buy DeAndre, so then they want them to go ahead and buy Barry Sanders as well. That it could mean that too, but there aren't many Lions theme teamers, so it's kind of a weird thing to target. I don't really know, but pretty solid card. But again, give me Kamara, give me Jonathan Taylor, give me Craig, give me Bo, obviously. But he could fall after those guys though. I mean, his stats look good. Like I said, has some really good stats in some spots. I do wish he had like 94, 93 speed. That would have been pretty cool. But again, it is what it is. And for the abilities today, I'm going to be rocking with Energizer, Spin Cycle, and Backfield Master. So these three abilities right here, pretty solid abilities, I feel like. You know, the Energizer is kind of going to keep our energy right. And I'll be spinning a lot with that 95 spin move. And then the Backfield Master is when my opponent eventually does start playing the run. The plan is to then put Texas routes and flat routes and have the better catching and route running from the backfield, and then as well as freight train. So that's the plan for today's gameplay. And yeah, let's hop into it. All right, here we go. Game number one. I believe that was our top three, and we're facing a full Bears team. He's got full Alvin too. So Bears team, he's got Singletary, he's got B Marsh. I really don't face that many Bears teams. I do know that their secondary is definitely weak, which kind of sucks because we are doing a running back gameplay today. So I'm not gonna be able to really exploit that too much. But yeah, definitely some good linebackers. You know, Khalil Mack, Singletary. This might be a tough game to run against. I mean, a tough team to run against. But I feel like DeAndre Swift can definitely get it done. He definitely can. And Swift's drip, by the way, in-game, elite. That's all I'm going to say about it. He is definitely elite drip, which definitely does play a factor into how the card does play. So keep that in mind. Here we go. DeAndre Swift, 5'8". So a really small back. I've been using Bo Jackson. This is obviously a little bit different. And give me my seal right there. And are we loose? We're going to get wrapped up already by Entrell Roll. Like I said, their DBs are not the greatest. One good spin, we could be loose here. Oh, he waited for me. I still outspun him. Why'd he wait for me like that? I shouldn't even cut that back. I would have easily had the corner right there. All right, so far, Swift does feel good, though. And by the way, his spin animation, even without spin cycle, is going to be butter just because he has a 95 spin. Up the gut. We're gone. We're gone here. We're gone to Swift. We're gone. No one should catch us. He's going to catch us, actually. 92 speed. It's a little bit low. It's a little bit low. Obviously, you can power this card up and throw him on a Lions team. And I thought I was gone right there. Hit that hole. But I guess, you know, theme team Entrell Roll is hawking us, which is concerning. And keep in mind, this card is not cheap. He's 800k. Keep that in mind, please. Just keep it in mind. And look at the 5'8 frame. And we spin that. Oh my, let me get caught by Khalil Mack. I got about two plays, and if they don't work, it's GG's. And again, we don't get a... it's Curtis Martin, actually, because he's tired. Okay, great. Phenomenal job right there by me for keeping Swift in the game. And also it being 4th and 6. And an amazing drive for DeAndre Swift bat might actually come to a close empty. He is in man. Damn. Okay. It's not what we actually wanted. Still. Okay. Empty drive. A really good drive though for Swift. A really good drive. We kind of fell apart in the red zone, but that typically happens in running back gameplay. So nothing new, but Swift did feel good on that first drive. Let's get a stop and let's try getting back on offense here. All right, so just like that, back on offense, inside the red zone again. He's gonna quit. All right, so I don't get my vengeance here. It's a 0-0 game. My opponent's gonna leave. Kind of a weird start to this gameplay, but hopefully game two was a lot better than game one did. And I'm sure out of everyone watching this video, probably like three of you guys will actually end up getting this card. Probably like three of you, which kind of sucks for limiteds. But so with that side here, there's the spin cycle. Dude, his spin cycle is nasty. I'm gonna get caught here though. I know I am. Yeah, I got stuck, lost my acceleration, but again, also 92 speed. You're gonna get caught a good amount here. You're definitely gonna get caught a good amount. This guy has inside stubs though, which is kind of tough, but we should be okay. I tried a little stun inside, Swift trying to show off the speed, and I keep getting caught. I'm trying to set corners, and I just cannot get it done right now. And we should get Swift open here. Flat, clear at the flat, and Swift's gonna get open as a pass catcher. Spin that, go Swift, good blocking, right? Oh, he actually got back up. Keyshawn had two pancakes on that, but oh, he's gonna quit already. Oh, this guy didn't have a good team though. I thought his top three was pretty decent. So another quit. No TDs yet with DeAndre Swift. Okay, so unfortunately, game number three does have us starting off on defense. We have to get a stop here before seeing our man DeAndre Swift again. But this guy has a full Saints team. He's got Teddy. He's got Alvin. Good run right there. Good block right there by Brandon Cooks, though, picking up my linebacker. That's respect. But yeah, he got his full Saints team with Teddy. That Teddy card isn't bad. You missed that gameplay yesterday card in the top right. And as well as the wide receiver teals. If you missed that video as well, go check that one out. I dropped that video before this one. Odds are YouTube sent the noty for that video and not this one. So yeah, but if you for whatever reason you want to see the updated wide receiver teals and didn't miss it, I did drop that video earlier today. Okay, so before our third drive with DeAndre, here are some things that I like about the card so far. One, his height. I like his height. His spin animation is really nice. A really good acceleration as well. Able to pick holes pretty well too. Good change of direction. Stuff like that I do like. Things I don't like, 92 speed. And that's probably the most important stat on a running back is the speed. Unless you're Derrick Henry and you're just huge and physically like dominant or whatever. But yeah, DeAndre Swift is not that. He's 5'8", which I like the height, but you got to be super fast if you're going to have this height. And he just doesn't. So we're going to try another run here. He's got very good linebackers, multiple inside stuffs. Not going to be an easy game to run against. I can already tell that. But he's playing cover three, so we can definitely get him involved in the pass game. Wheels should get open. There we go. Wheels open. One-on-one with Glenn. Make a miss. Go. Go, Swift. And I'm making guys miss, but then when I want to accelerate, it's just not there. I mean, the acceleration is there. I'm getting a 92 speed fast, but against these full theme teams, and a lot of you guys either are cheating at running back or don't have our running back strat cards, so you're not getting that added speed boost, and you're most likely going up against a bunch of full theme teams with full, you know, safety strat cards and stuff like that. So definitely does make it a little bit harder to run the ball in this game, I feel like. Now, underneath the cover three, we're going to get it open. Shook him. Go Swift. Ooh, we actually almost broke that, and we are falling forward. Does he get fights for extra yards? He does, actually. Okay, that's also kind of nice. He's one inside stuff, right? I'm surprised about how much disruption that man Quinton Williams actually made. Should get a good pull right there, and we're out here with Swift falling forward again. Let's go with a little clear out. Honestly, these corner outs aren't bad, and we might be able to get Swift open underneath. He's actually used. No, he's not. I might get it over his head. There we go. Swift with a touchdown. Let's go. We get a touchdown. Oh my goodness. Okay, so right there, that is why, I mean, I don't have a hot route master quarterback, but even if you do, having that added catching and route running is just so nice, especially on a card that doesn't hit the short routing threshold or doesn't have any crazy catching like a CMC or Kamara card would have. So definitely nice to see right there from DeAndre Swift. A nice drive, didn't run the ball that well, but yep, definitely a good pass catching drive for DeAndre there. And let's, I'm gonna take my three here. I kind of ran out of time. And I just realized I was talking to myself for about 5 minutes there. I did not hit the record button. Thankfully, you guys did not miss any offensive snaps. It was only defense, and this dude just embarrassed me again with Teddy Bridgewater and the Saints theme team offense. But it's okay. We're still trying our best. Get outside here. Cut that back. Ooh. Ah, damn. I think I hit the back button too soon. I thought I was going to commit to the outside, and then I redirected, and then when I did that, I lost my speed and acceleration. So we're going to try the little homemade screen here. It actually should work. We get two blockers out in front. One more. Pick him up. Attaboy. Should have shown the spin cycle here. Oh, he actually did a good job at not committing to that. Smart player. He knows I got that spin cycle on DeAndre. He knows I got it. Let's try finishing this thing off. I could try. No, we're going to walk this thing in. Let's go. We had a rushing touchdown too today. So started the gameplay off with two games, no touchdown. And now, oh, we're hitting that. Okay, I see us. Okay, DeAndre. I didn't know they had that in the game. Is that part of the new update? They got Kralo in the motion cap suit now. But my opponent's experiencing network issues. Please, no. Oh, he's still here. It's man coverage. I'm going to throw this thing up to DeAndre. Go make a play. Oh, my. Yeah, he's so small. And he's getting caught by Isaiah Simmons. Oh, man. Getting caught by Isaiah Simmons, bro. Good work. Let's see. Good cut. Spin that. Oh, yeah, she got it. Let's go. Go swift. Please end it like this. No, we're getting caught. We're getting caught by Deion. Oh, yeah, she went for the strip. I thought he was going to play off the sideline because I kept spinning, but he didn't. He stuck with his guns right there and almost went for the strip tackle. Almost had it. Like I said, this guy's a risk taker. But it's kind of weird because you feel like when you get into that second level and make a couple guys miss that you should be finishing those big runs for touchdowns. But with Swift, you just don't do that at all. I'm going to try spinning that back again. Ooh, if we keep that block, if I kind of get by that guy, that's a walk-in right there. That is a walk-in. But yeah, you know what I mean? Like you feel like you should be finishing those, but you don't because he's got 92 speed. And I know I said you could power him up and do all these things with this card, but he's also 800K, man. It's ridiculous, man, for real. Get open. Oh, yeah, she got. Wow, that was perfect. Good weave. That was why you like having a 5'8 back right there and another touchdown for DeAndre Swift. I believe it's third of the gameplay in three games. So, I mean, it checks out, right? I mean, he had a good debut. All right, guys, so that is going to do it for the DeAndre Swift gameplay. And like I said in the intro, this card isn't worth it. He's actually a really good card, though. I think everything besides his speed is really good. Like, his spin animation was butter. The way he fights for extra yards, his carrying, his height, and his weight combination really nice. As a pass catcher, he also gets really good abilities, too. So I like Swift as far as that goes. Also does get joystick, by the way. I'm not sure if I actually said that. This card does get human joystick. Probably should have said that in the intro. That's on me, but he does get that ability. My bad. I should have said that in the intro. But the only problem with this card is this speed. His animations, his height, his weight, his build. All that stuff is really good on this card. But again, if you can put him on a Lions team, you know, plus 2 speed, that's 94. If you power him up, that's 95. If you put a strat card into him, 96 speed on this card. It's pretty good. I feel like, yeah, just the speed's the only real problem with him because I felt like I was putting myself in position to break those big runs with the spin cycle. But then just getting caught by... You know, you saw with Isaiah Simmons on that one wheel route that I thought I should have maybe lobbed it over the top of his head. Janoris Jenkins caught us a couple times. So, yeah, that's the only real problem with this card. But if you are still watching, let's comment the star emoji for a chance to be shouted out in the next video. And if you are new here, hit that subscribe button for notifications. We post daily Madden 22 content. And as always, I will see you boys in the next one.